Hey YouTube fans, this is Hat Hair Harvey, and I'm here cooking some chop suey tonight. I figured I'd give this a try to see just what I could do as far as dish. This is something I got from my mother. She started cooking this maybe 35 years ago. Wonderful stuff. It's just plain old chop suey. I do a little bit different recipe than she does. She buys a store-bought package of vegetables. I, on the other hand, like to chop my own, basically because I'm cheap. So anyways, here we go. We've got celery. Some good, delicious bok choy. It's good stuff, okay? Can't have chop suey without bok choy. Napa cabbage. A big old head of Napa cabbage, and I want you to know, I'm not scared of E. coli, so bring it on. So here's the Napa cabbage. Chicken broth. Gotta have chicken broth because it gives it a little bit of flavor and makes for a nice color. Got some sticky rice, some Calrose rice. You can't have chop suey on Uncle Ben's rice. It's just not the same. Okay? So we got the rice. We're going to use some cornstarch. That's just to help thicken the sauce up a little bit. It's not making chicken and vegetable soup. Garlic powder. Got to have soy sauce. Okay? Got to show the label. Black pepper. Sea salt. I know it should be peanut, but I'm using olive oil, extra virgin. And our mystery meat is going to be some boneless chicken. Just smell that. Can you say salmonella? Okay, YouTube fans, first thing we're going to do is we're going to start with the rice. Here's our sticky rice. It's got to be sticky to be authentic Orient. So what you do is you want to take 2 cups. Got a 2-cup measure right here. There's 2 cups. That's going to go in our rice cooker, high tech. You want to rinse your rice out. This crap, you're supposed to rinse twice. I'm only going to rinse it once, because I like my rice extra sticky. That's just me. Now, that's good enough. All I'm going to do is just drain it out, get the water out of there. Perfect. Now, we've got to add 2 cups of water. Actually, you want to add more water than that. You gotta add a little bit more water so the sticky rice doesn't burn. There we go. Got a lid on it. This is going on the stove. Right over here. I'm gonna set a timer for 20 minutes because we want this to steam. We don't exactly want it to burn on the bottom, okay? So it's set on low heat. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start working on getting the chicken cut and the vegetables cut. I'm going to get the hair out of the way. That's backwards in the camera. That's tricky. Okay. So here we go. We've got our salmonella chicken. Okay, let me get this crap out of the way here so we can look at our salmonella chicken. There we go. So we have an angle on the salmonella chicken. It's already been deboned. All we're going to do is cut this into about 1-inch square cubes. Now, I don't have any fancy chef equipment, but I do like to eat. And this is going to come out pretty good. I can guarantee, as Justin Wilson would have said. And you know, one of my favorite lines with Justin Wilson is he would always say, "You gotta cook with them wine." And, I'm having them wine off camera. Got friends whose kids are gonna watch this later on, and I don't want to be a bad influence on them. Okay. This is about a pound and a half of chicken. You can go 2 pounds. This is a big recipe. I'm a single guy. I'm going to eat this the next 2 days. It's just that good. This will be dinner tonight. You know, it's kind of late. Right now it's about 15 minutes to 10. So, get this chicken crap done here. Now, you know, salmonella is not necessarily a great thing. So make sure that when you're cooking, you go ahead and you rinse your hands. Don't use the same utensils on your vegetables. Otherwise, you could end up having to hover around the toilet a little bit longer than you really want to. That's not any fun. No, I can't make Mr. Cook sounds. That would be a total ripoff. Mr. Cook has a wonderful style. I appreciate the way that he presents his cooking expertise. Very entertaining, very informative, full of information and good recipes. One of my favorite recipes. I like the trailer trash barbecue chicken food crap. I think that's probably the best recipe that he, well, next to the frog. You gotta include the frog legs in that. That's good stuff there, Maynard. Even if I'm not from the South, okay? And I don't live in a trailer park. Although, there are a bunch of Eskimos that live in trailer parks. Let me tell you, I don't want to know any of them. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start with some olive oil in the pan. I have to change the camera angle. The olive oil is going in the pan right there. I'm using a good generous couple of tablespoons. Okay, here we go. We're going to start cooking. I've got the chicken. The salmonella chicken I'm going to put in there right now. You can see that in the pan, salmonella chicken, a couple of tablespoons of olive oil. We're going to put some sea salt, lots of sea salt, I love salt, okay? Sea salt's in there, we got to put some pepper, that's in there, plenty of pepper, a ton of garlic powder. How much you want to bet I set the smoke alarm off? Okay, I'll go ahead and work that around. I'm working with high heat here. That's not the best thing for olive oil, but who the heck cares? Soy sauce, drown it in soy sauce, drown, 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 drown. There we go. Okay, now, you can imagine the smells that are coming out of this. This stuff is going to cook pretty fast. We got to get a utensil to move the goods around. There's one right there. Okay. Stir our chicken around. Let that brown. That smells pretty darn good. Okay, now first thing I'm going to get started on, I've got the bok choy. We're going to let that go for now. Celery. I like my celery kind of on the tender side. I don't like chewy celery unless I'm having it with some sort of a sauce or dip, peanut butter and salt, whatever the heck you like with celery. Now, you know, I do want you to know, I did clean this cutting board and I flipped it over, so we're not going to get any cross-contamination. That's it. Nasty chicken. Okay. So, like I said, I'm not scared of E. coli. Why, heck, I got one or two of them in my body. Why should I be afraid? Okay, there's the celery that goes in the mix. Okay. stir that around and around and around. Chicken's starting to brown. It's got, you know, cooking a little bit. Now, we're going to cook up that celery so it's nice and tender. Okay, that's going. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to do the bok choy. Okay, because this is pretty big stuff on its own. It's actually, you know, it's pretty clean. I mean, normally it's pretty grungy looking, dirty, you know, like it just came out of the field. And, you know, the people that take the vegetables trample all over it. But this is pretty good looking stuff. I feel kind of safe. What the heck? Let's live dangerously. And this is, that's about a half pound of bok choy. Okay, we're going to put that in the mix. Well, actually, no, hold on. Just a second. We're going to stir this around. Stir it, stir it. Stir it around. Stir it around. Stir it around. I'm getting dizzy. Oh, man. Oh, crap. I better look back at the camera. Okay? Anyway, so we're making some salmonella chop suey chicken. That's going to come out pretty good. 50-second rule. Okay, now we stir our bok choy into that. Sorry, folks, I don't have a fancy setup. Can't show you what I'm doing on the stove, but I can bring the cooking to you. Ooh. That's the timer. You know what? Rice is done. Well, it should be. Okay, now, my neighbor downstairs has a 6 or 7 month old baby, so I can't whack the onion on the counter like I want to, and I don't have a rolling pin, so I have to use a stick. So I wanted to do this. This ought to be pretty fun. There it is. Okay, yeah. Stir. Now all this other crap that's in the way I was discussing, oh my goodness, any self-respecting chef would never allow that kind of a view, but I'm not a self-respecting chef. So, I'm just a middle-aged, pot-bellied, wine-drinking, love-to-eat kind of guy. You know what? I put more soy sauce. Love that soy sauce. Now, let's go ahead and let's add our cornstarch and our chicken broth. Okay? What we're going to do is we're going to take a cup of chicken broth. Okay? I'm going to pour our chicken broth right in there, just like that. There it is. And then we're going to add at least a couple of tablespoons cornstarch, because this is going to thicken it up. There it is. Stir that in. Okay, gotta stir our vegetables. Oh, I gotta turn the heat down. That's way too hot. Okay, now we're making soup. We're not in the business of making soup here. Okay, this is chop suey. Oop. There we go. Got that back in there. Oh man, vegetables are flying everywhere. Okay, so we got our cornstarch stirred into our chicken broth, and we're gonna pour that right in. Just like that. Get that out of the way. Okay. Oh. Now we're talking. Oh, yes. And just the heat a little bit. Turn that down. Now I got it back up a little bit because we want to heat up or cornstarch, so it thickens. Oh my goodness, it's setting already. Oh jeez, look at this. Oh, we've got our yummy chop suey vegetables. Go right on top of there, just like that. Oh my goodness, yep, got you. One more spoonful, one more spoonful. Oh, there we go. That's better, that's much better. Now, you know, I'm not a skinny chef, okay? Here we go. That is so good. Anyways, have fun making this recipe for Salmonella chicken chop suey.